Pop Opera.
Welcome one and all to my channel. Today we'll be exploring Shop, a pop opera, created by Jack Stauber, who you might know as the person behind Opal. I actually considered making an explore video on Opal, but when I saw Shop, I had a change of plans. So who's Jack Stauber, and what are you going to expect throughout this video? Jack Stauber is a musician and animator with a unique style that's both fascinating and strange, but in a good way, as you watch and listen to their collections of songs. During Shop, we get presented with a 2D and stop-motion style video that follows a man doing shopping while occasionally getting interrupted by other shoppers or his own thoughts about life and the deeper meaning behind his thoughts. We also get fun songs, and today I'll be explaining what I believe the messages behind each song means. I recommend that you go watch Shop, a pop opera first so you can craft your own thoughts about each song without being influenced by me, because everything I'll be saying is just my own opinion. Plus, it's a fun watch. So if you're ready, let's jump right into the video. In the beginning, we get a fun little intro with the items in the shop singing the title of the video, Shop, a Pop Opera. The scene then opens to free samples, one being strawberry and the other being raspberry, the sign in the back instructing the customers that they can only take one sample. Our protagonist is struggling to pick which sample he wants because he can only have one, and the person running the stand just told him to take one without overthinking it. But in the end, our protagonist does not take one and tells the worker that he'll return later. Already, we can see that our protagonist is a bit of an overthinker. Something as simple as choosing one of two samples of different flavors overwhelmed him enough to make him put the issue off to the side to deal with later. While walking away, he soon pulls out his grocery list, and the first item is milk. He looks around while repeating the word, but soon got jump-scared by an elderly person saying pecan. He was confused at first until he noticed pecan cookies at the top shelves that the elderly person couldn't reach. Being the good guy that he is, he helped give the other customer the cookies, but it turns out it wasn't what they wanted. He suggested that the elderly person should try it because they might like it, and they responded by saying they might in the future. Our protagonist then looks back at the shelves and grabs another box, hoping it would be the correct one, but when he looks back, the elderly person was gone. Anyways, he found the milk and was about to check it off the list until he realized the milk was expired. This leads to our first song of Shop, Milk. The song asks questions such as, what kind of milk were you in? What kind of life did you live through? More and more questions were asked, wanting to understand what the life of this milk was like while showing Polaroid photos of the milk carton. Giving it some thought, you can connect the song to life and death. The milk is expired, which could represent someone who died, and the questions asked throughout the song are only asked to see if the milk accomplished enough throughout their life before they expired. There were even visuals of tears in the beginning, giving sadness to it all. Did this milk live a life worth living before they expired? Either having a family or learning to believe in themselves before death? Did they give their life purpose, or will no one care when they're gone? Looking back on the elderly person we met moments ago, this makes me think about them. The elderly person was offered to try something new, but declined and wanted to stick with what they were used to. They did say they would consider in the future, but the future is unpredictable. You might run out of time before you could try the things you always said you wanted to try. This could leave you with regrets and make your life feel less meaningful. And another thing that comes with death is the fact that you'll either be forgotten or remembered. When the elderly person suddenly disappeared, our acknowledgement about it was brief before we continued doing our shopping trip. We immediately forgot about the elderly person when we continued. In my opinion, milk's deeper meaning is to question one's own life. If you were to die right now, would you be satisfied with how your life turned out? Would you rest in peace or have regrets? So before you expire, live your life and make experiences meaningful for you. If you want to be remembered, leave an impact in the world. If you've been saying you wanted to try something for a long time but haven't yet, try it because you might regret not being able to do so when you still have the time. And that was milk. Returning back to our protagonist, they ended up finding milk that hasn't expired and continued with their shopping. What's the next item? Bread. He finds the bread and suddenly another customer appears and takes one of them. Our protagonist was curious about the bread because it seemed interesting and asked the other customer if it was good for sandwiches, but the customer responded by saying that it was for their dog. This customer seems eccentric and a little bit snooty, maybe a little materialistic too, because they were planning to go to an auction for an antique walnut, and the reason why they don't buy normal bread at the store for themselves is because they have their bread specially made. The customer soon left and our protagonist stared at the bread while saying artisanal. I didn't know what that meant until I looked it up. Artisanal means of a product, especially food or drinks, made in a traditional and non-mechanized way. With this, we get shown the next song, Bread. The song opens with things you probably saw on products before, such as all natural and pure natural. And throughout the song, everything was described as artisanal, and at some point, our protagonist questioned how others see him while questioning himself. What's an artisanal me? Now, if I had to guess, I believe the deeper meaning behind the song is what makes you, you. Do the people make themselves, or do the material possessions they own make their character? Let's be honest, we live in a materialistic world. People guess a lot about you based on your success. If you have a luxurious car or a fancy home, people actually acknowledge you as a person, especially when you show off your success through items. If you don't own expensive things or lose your success, you're nothing. Thinking back on the customer we met, they seem like a clear example of this. Materialism, I mean. This customer isn't afraid to express their wealth to a stranger, and they leave us with an impression that this person is successful and has the money to spend on whatever things they want. And they seem to care a lot about what they buy and consume for themselves. Anyways, that was the end of the song, and our protagonist takes some bread and checks it off the list. Now what's the next item on the list? It's toilet paper, and nearby a couple accidentally knocked a shelf, causing an item to fall to the ground and shatter. A store worker assumed our protagonist broke it, but he denied it, so the worker proceeded to clean up the mess, but ended up getting injured. The protagonist worries about the worker because they're bleeding, but the worker went on a speech saying that the broken glass could be put together with time, but will never be the same, and compared the situation to his cut finger. And when the worker said mess, our protagonist thinks about the word, and this leads to our next song, Paper Towels. I believe what the song is telling us is that there will always be messes in life that can't be avoided. In life, we have many ups and downs, and all we can do is try our best to navigate our existence with these obstacles that are inevitable. Just like the worker who got their finger cut, this was just another mess in their life, and there's no rewind button to prevent this, so the worker just accepts the cut and acknowledges that it will get better over time. Cleaning up a mess helps a lot with the situation, and allowing their cut to heal with time is their way of cleaning up the mess, I assume. In life, many things are unavoidable. Sure, things can be done to prevent messes from happening, but there will always be something that can't be stopped. For example, aging. It's a natural part of life, and we can't fight against it, so instead of trying to stop it, we accept it as a part of our life. There are messes that can be cleaned, and there are messes that are unavoidable. In life, we just have to accept the messes that come with it. We live, we learn, and navigate through life despite the messes. And that was toilet paper. Speaking of toilet paper, our protagonist found the toilet paper too, and we soon move on to the next item on the list. Oatmeal! While looking at his list, another customer jumps in and asks the protagonist to move his cart because it was blocking their path. The customer seems almost in a rush and extremely anxious. Turns out, this customer has every second of their life on a schedule, and when they're late or miss something on this schedule, it stresses them out. They even believe getting certain items on their list is now impossible because they wasted their time talking to the protagonist and rushed off. While walking away, they complain that they now don't have anything for lunch on Thursday. I'm also the type of person who likes to plan ahead, so I guess I understand the frustration of having your plans ruined, but this customer is taking it to another level. Anyway, the protagonist then returns back to looking for oatmeal, and he does, but it surprises him how much oatmeal he can get for just one box, saying it's enough to feed him for a long time. And this leads us to the next song, Oatmeal. Oatmeal seems to be taking over his life now. Being the only food he eats and using oatmeal to brush his teeth, he even describes his work and his home as oatmeal. Everything is oatmeal. My oatmeal routine. But unexpectedly, disaster appears, disrupting his oatmeal routine. Thanks to the encounter with the customer, I believe this one is pretty easy to understand. When you have a routine in life that you've been doing for a long time, you're used to everything being the same. And because you repeat the motion so many times, when something unexpectedly goes wrong, things derail from there. Let's say your routine is making sure to pack your phone in your bag before you leave for work, but one day you forgot it because it was charging in a different location that you're not used to putting your phone at. That one break from your routine leads to a butterfly effect that causes more issues throughout your routine. For example, let's also say that in your routine, you always make sure to call your mother in the afternoon to check up on her, but because you left your phone, that part of your routine is also broken. And when your routine starts breaking, you become more forgetful and clumsy with the rest of your routine, and that can lead to quite a disaster for yourself. So I believe the deeper meaning of this song is that having a routine can be a good thing, but don't rely on it too much because once it breaks, you'll struggle to figure out how to handle a broken routine. So have a routine, but don't get too comfortable and expect the unexpected, because life will always be unpredictable. You can be thorough with everything you plan, but something will always go wrong, so just be prepared. Anyways, our protagonist gets the oatmeal and we move on to the next item on the list. Coffee! For a moment, our protagonist thought he had the aisle to himself, but another customer jumps in and they seem pretty hyper and drinking a cup of coffee. This customer rambles on a lot until they suddenly lost energy and passed out. It's almost like they crashed. Luckily for them, the protagonist raised their cup, allowing the customer to take a sip of their coffee, and they re-energized. They jumped from topic to topic, even realizing that they forgot their son, and after getting distracted again, the customer left while saying that they need a refill. The word need sticks with our protagonist, and this leads to the next song, Coffee. I first heard the song all over TikTok, and I believe this one is the most popular of them all, only because I heard it everywhere. All the songs are great, but I personally like this one the most. Anyways, what do I believe the deeper meaning of this song is? First, I must define the word vices. A vice is a bad or unhealthy habit seen in the eyes of society. Now, relying on coffee to be able to function in the morning isn't seen as anything wrong in the eyes of society. However, people that rely on coffee rely on it similarly to people who use drugs and alcohol. Now, of course, coffee isn't as bad as those things, but it still consumes people's lives, because if your only way to function is by consuming coffee, you know what that's called? An addiction. People who use drugs and alcohol to cope and people who use coffee to remain awake are both just as addicted to their own types of vices. And this is what I believe the deeper meaning of the song is. Addiction. Now we return back to our protagonist and he got the coffee and is moving on to the last item on the list. Cheese! Simple, right? Nope. We now get introduced to the five aisles of grief and the final songs. Our protagonist is overwhelmed by the wide selection of cheese options. Funny enough, this reminds me of the beginning. If the protagonist struggled just to pick between two samples, it's not a surprise that he's struggling more with picking a cheese because there are multiple types of cheeses that he can choose from. The five aisles of grief is actually a fitting name because it seems like he's going through the five stages of grief. Denial, anger, bargaining, depression, and acceptance. I don't think I need to over-explain the song's meaning or purpose, but I will say our protagonist's overthinking and indecisiveness shows a lot during this part. Anyways, he picks a cheese at random, allowing the world to make the choice for him. But when he looks at the cheese he got, he didn't like what he selected, claiming he could have picked something better. And just like getting an epiphany, he realized he could make the choice on his own and be satisfied with it because he was the one to make the choice. No one else, he made the choice. We reference all the past items we collected on the journey until the protagonist runs back to the free sample stands and makes his choice. He wanted strawberries. He takes the sample and I'm so proud because he didn't overthink it and actually made a decision, and now he has his prize for this victory. He tasted the sample and he loved it. Though he still wanted to try the other sample despite being allowed only one, and of course he was denied the other sample. He accepted it, and this was the end of Shop, a pop opera. A man going shopping and encounters paired with songs that have a deeper meaning that makes us question a lot about our lives. Expired milk making you think about life and death, bread making you think about materialism, toilet paper making you think about the messes in life, oatmeal making you think about routines in life, coffee making you think about addictions in life, and lastly cheese. An indecisive person's worst nightmare, but if you learn to break free from your indecisiveness, things can get better. Life has many ups and downs, but we'll always find a way to make it through. And that was Shop, a pop opera. If you haven't listened to any of the songs, I highly recommend that you do. They're fun and catchy, plus the visuals are fun to look at. As always, the links are in the description, and I better not catch you dying on me. I hope you have a good day, and goodbye! Like and subscribe!